student, then I'm like, well, pretty soon I'll start to believe it. And then he just got upset and left the room.
Well, I feel grateful that I could have contributed to your father getting upset.
It was good.
Anytime you guys want to use me in that way, that's a good example, though. You're right. Give me another example. Yeah. Could have done better. Okay. You know, there's nothing wrong with telling yourself you could have done better, as long as you aren't always doing that and ignoring the things you do well. One of the problems with being a perfectionist, how many of you consider yourselves to be perfectionists? Raise your hand high, be proud of it. It's okay to be a perfectionist, get you to strive higher. Here's the problem with being a perfectionist. You're never satisfied. Right. Here's an example of how a perfectionist learned to be a perfectionist. Here's a swimmer who comes back from a meet after qualifying for Olympic trials, which I think is an unbelievable accomplishment. She qualified in one of her events, her best event, I think was the 2-3. She didn't do too good in the 100 fly, though, okay, at this meet. Her mother greeted her at the airport. She called her mother to let her know that she had done really well. But her mother, she just left the message. She left all of her times, too. The first thing out of her mother's mouth wasn't, honey, I'm so proud of you, Olympic trials, add a baby, you know, way to go, girl. What her mother said was, what happened to you in the 100? Not congratulations. So you know how, you know, perfectionists learn to do that to themselves. If you never pat yourself on the back, you will never feel confident, regardless of how much success you have. It's kind of like bringing home a 95, and you look at the 95 and you go, well, look at all these I got wrong. Okay, so what we're talking about is you have to begin to advertise for yourself. Now, how do you do that? You do that by using what I call affirmations. And I told you a story yesterday about the runner with hills. Remember that runner who made signs that said she loved hills? Okay, I need conscious recognition to know that we have a conscious group here. Now remember, I don't mind you being unconscious, because as a hypnotist, I love working with people when they're unconscious. But I actually, for what we're doing right now, would like you to be somewhat conscious. Do you remember me talking about that story yesterday?
Yes.
Excellent. Okay. The affirmation she used was that she liked hills. Now let's talk about what you do with affirmations. Here's where you are right now. Okay? Here's where you want to be. Here's your goal. This is how you'd like to feel about yourself. You use the affirmations to get you there. Not to trick you. Okay, we're not talking about positive thinking here necessarily. We're talking about using an affirmation to lead you in that direction. Let me give you an example. First of all, what is an affirmation? Let me back up. An affirmation is a positive statement that you make about yourself that you want to be true, that's not true yet, but you write it as if it's true this moment. So like with the runner with hills, I love hills. Was it true? No. Did she believe it? No. Did it matter? No, because you're leading yourself in that direction. Here's an example. I had a swimmer who would fade consistently at the end of his races. So we came up, and he would believe that, and he would expect that it would happen. So we came up with an affirmation, as the race gets longer, I get stronger. Now, if you can come up with a rhyme, that's kind of cool, because your unconscious mind likes those. It goes in there. I had another swimmer who used to faint whenever she felt pain, she'd give in to it. So we came up with the affirmation, when I feel the pain, I begin to gain, which kind of motivated her to push through it. So an affirmation is a positive statement you make about yourself that will lead you in that direction. So anybody want to come up with one? You're here, you want to be here, like, you know, I hate fly and you want to love fly. Anybody, can we get any creative responses? There's got to be some poets in this group. Or maybe, actually, better yet, how about this? Who can give me an example of how they're feeling right now and they want to change it where they'd like to be? Let's do it that way. That's better. Then we can use the whole group to come up with an affirmation. Come on. You've got to take a risk, though. You've got to get out of your comfort zone. Very, very scary thing to do. I hope none of you do it. terrifying. Do you understand what I'm asking? I want to know, you say, okay, this is how I feel right now about this event, about this race, about handling pressure. This is how I would like to feel. That's what I want. I want you. Here's where I am, and this is where I want to be. And one question, one rule. You can't all respond at the same time. It gets very unruly when you do that. Yes. Right now you're not a good flyer?
I'm awful.
You're awful. Do you want to be a good flyer?
Yeah.
Okay. Can we let's come up with something more creative than I love fly, or I'm a great fly. Come on. Some of you guys must be good at this. Come up with something that's... How do we do affirmations? Positive statement, as if it's true right now. Yes?
Well, I didn't make it up, but I got it from 3510. You'll never be the best, and I won't settle for anything less.
You'll never be...
the best, and I won't settle for anything less.
Okay, you won't be the best, and I won't settle for anything less. It has a ring to it. It's a little confusing, though.
Yeah. Well, he used to say it to his competitors.
Oh, he would say it to his competitors.
Or he'd say it to his
competitors. Okay. All right, yes. When I swim fly, you want to write these down, we'll take the top 10. You don't all have to write it down, unless you want to change your attitude towards fly. When I swim fly, I reach for the sky. I like that, that's kind of slick. Come on, there's a lot of creativity in this room, it's not just standing here in front of you. What else? Huh? Yes? Okay, now, what is wrong with this kind of affirmation? When I swim fly, no, I'm glad you brought it up. When I swim fly, I'm not going to die.
It's like saying don't.
What's the image that comes up when you think about it? I won't die.
I'm
going to die. That's okay, though. What else? Do we have any others to fly?
It's a lie that I'm...
That's negative too, right? Yes. I'll try when I swim fly. Okay? All right, now listen up. You don't have to rhyme it. It doesn't have to rhyme. You want to do yours? You want to do breast? Okay. How do you feel about breaststroke? Oh, you mean you've got an affirmation for breaststroke? You're not good at breaststroke? Okay. All right, let's switch. So, when I swim fly, or wait a minute, what is it? When I swim fly, I reach for the sky. Or I love fly, or fly is my best stroke, yes?
I'm the best when I swim breast.
I am the best when I swim breast. Did you have that too? We'll give you credit for that. Yeah.
When I swim breast, I'll ace that test.
Hey, let me tell you something. Let me tell you something about affirmations. It doesn't matter how silly or corny they may sound to other people. If it rings for you, you want to do it. Let me give you an example. I had a runner I worked with last year, or the year before, a high school runner who, at the end of cross-country season, injured herself. She was one of the high...